Hello, my name is David. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, and you already know this is going to be an interesting year when San Marino is ranked 10th in the bookmakers. So last year I made a video about the Eurovision Song Contest and my opinions on some of the songs and the decisions that were made about the countries having to change them, and I decided to make another one this year as a follow-up. I think the first thing to note is that there are two songs less than there would have been last year. Armenia was going to come back this year, but they ultimately didn't because they were, and I quote, unable to put an entry together on short notice, even though they had a whole year. According to this fan-made wiki that I steal all of my information from, it might also have something to do with Azerbaijan, but regardless of what the reason is, they're not coming back this year. The other country that won't be returning is Belarus. They had already chosen a song, but it was a political song, which is against the rules. The EBU told them to either change the song or make a new song, which they did, but that violated the exact same rule, so now they're disqualified. What this means is that for the first time since 2014, there will be less than 40 countries participating. Now last year I mentioned that some countries would be holding a national final as usual, therefore potentially picking a different artist, and I specifically mentioned the Estonian Uku Suviste, who had already tried twice before and said he would try again this year, so I am happy to announce that he has once again succeeded and will participate for Estonia in the Eurovision Song Contest this year. Then again, he didn't really have that much of a competition this year. Last year he went up against Jakub Tuisk, who, in all honesty, probably should have won, but he didn't participate this year. So is it really any surprise that Uku won? Who else could possibly go up against Uku Suvi? Anyway, Uku Suviste is coming back this year. However, not all of last year's artists will be returning. Obviously, we won't be seeing Val and Athena Manoukian because Belarus and Armenia withdrew, but there are also 13 countries that picked a different artist while the remaining 26 didn't. Here is a chart that I made, but in case you don't feel like looking up who sent which artist, Ulrike Brandstorp, The Mamas, Axo Kankaranta, Benentam, Ben Dalek, Tom Lieb, Elisa, Diodato, Demir Kedjo, Arelena Ara, Sandro Little Big, and Alicia Shemplinska will not be returning this year. Other than that, all of the artists from last year return. Well, for the most part, Belgium's Hooverphonic actually has a different singer. It's kind of a vague story, but essentially they once had Gijke as a singer, but then she left and was replaced by Luca, but then Gijke wanted back in, so Luca had to leave, and apparently this was told to her via a video call? Now that makes it sound really stupid, but yeah, it kind of is actually. I've probably missed some details, but the main point is that Luca would have been the singer last year, and now it's going to be Gijke instead. And then there's San Marino, who is still sending Zanit, but since last year she has joined forces with none other than fucking Flo Rida. Well, that explains why she's 10th in the bookmakers. Now I'll give you some more song opinions, but I'm gonna do it a little differently than last year. I'm gonna look at the top 5 and bottom 5 countries from my top 41 that I made last year, and I'll be comparing their new songs with their old songs and seeing if they've improved or not. So my top 5 from last year looked like this, and we can already bump Armenia off because they're not participating this year. So let's start with Germany. I don't feel hate, I just feel sorry. No. Quick reminder that Germany was my absolute favorite last year, and for some reason they've decided on not sending Ben Dalek, but instead sending whatever the hell this is. The biggest letdown, however, is North Macedonia. Their song from last year was such a bop, and this year they have some boring slow song instead that I am not interested in at all. Vasil, what are you doing, man? As for Russia, I'm not entirely sure what my opinion on their song is, but I probably like their song from last year more. So essentially, Iceland is the only country from my top 5 last year who stayed consistent with the quality of their song. So what about the bottom 5? Well, I'm gonna say right now that all of these countries have definitely improved in my opinion, and especially Croatia. Last year they had some outdated ballad, kind of like what North Macedonia has this year, but their song from this year is so good! It's almost like Croatia and North Macedonia have decided to swap. In fact, I'm willing to say that Croatia is the only country that spent their extra year well and actually looked at the feedback they received. All of the other songs are either a little bit better, a little bit worse, a lot worse, or the exact same fucking thing as last year, but Croatia is by far the country that has improved the most from last year, so good job, Croatia. Slovenia, on the other hand, hasn't improved that much, but still a little. Their song is called Amen, and Austria also has a song called Amen, so we're having some religious themes this year. Meanwhile, in Finland,
I'm leading the light from the dark side.
Is it any surprise, though, that Finland is sending a rock song? Yeah. So by now you're probably all asking, hey David, which song is your favorite? Well, I don't know. I haven't really looked into it that much yet. According to the bookmakers, Malta is going to win, and if that happens, not only will it be their first win, but also, Destiny will be the first person ever to win both the Junior and the regular Eurovision Song Contest, which is kind of awesome, so good luck, Destiny. As for my favorite, well, I do like Malta's song, as well as the aforementioned Croatia and Iceland, but also, and I feel like a lot of people are going to disagree with me on this, but I like Belgium. No, really, I do. The bookmakers currently rank Belgium 20th, which is 3 spots lower than they ranked their song from last year, but honestly, I don't really know why I even look at the bookmakers anymore, because other than like the first 3 spots, they have no idea what they're talking about. Despite that though, online lists also consistently rank Belgium somewhere in the lower half of the list, which I don't understand at all. Even my sister said she prefers their song from last year because it's less repetitive, which makes literally zero sense whatsoever. How can you say this song is repetitive when the old one is worse? Half of the lyrics are "release me," it uses the exact same verse twice, everything sounds exactly the same except for the ending, I guess, but even that's similar, and you're telling me that their song from this year is repetitive? I do not understand you. Well, that's it for now. I'll see if I can make a top 39 video soon, but until then, thanks for watching. If you liked this video, give it a like. If you didn't like this video, give it a dislike, I don't care. Leave a comment telling me what your favorite song is from the Eurovision Song Contest this year, subscribe to my channel if you want to see more from me, and activate the bell if you want to be notified whenever I upload. Until next time, goodbye! In fact, I'm willing to say that Croatia is the only country that spent their extra year Okay. Leave a comment telling me what your I'm just gonna restart the entire outro because it's garbage.